We recently talked about diverticulitis here on our channel. Did you watch the video? Diverticulitis is an inflammation of the internal walls of the intestine. It is mainly characterized by the formation of small and bulging cysts and sacs called diverticula that get inflamed and cause the disease. But how are the diverticula formed? It is not yet known how the diverticula are formed. A theory is that diets poor in fiber contribute to their formation. The lack of fiber in the diet hardens the feces, which causes constipation. We end up having to push harder when defecating, which pressures the colon and the intestines and forms these cysts, the diverticula. The buildup of stool causes inflammation. Thinking about that, we decided to talk about the possible complications of diverticulitis. Intestinal obstruction. This is a serious complication of diverticulitis, caused by intense inflammation that prevents the passage of liquids and feces through the intestine. It causes bloating, abdominal cramps, and vomiting. A partial obstruction can be solved by medication and fasting, but a serious one may require surgical procedures. Abscess. An abscess is the buildup of pus, which is formed in infections and tissue inflammations. It causes pain and fever. In these cases, the treatment is done with antibiotics prescribed by a doctor, and in some cases, it might be necessary to drain the pus. Bleeding. When there is blood in stools, it means bleeding or hemorrhage that needs to be detected through a colonoscopy. In severe bleedings, it might be necessary to do some more complex procedures, such as angiography or even surgeries. Enjoying the video? Then give it a like and share it with your friends to help the channel. Fistula. A fistula is an abnormal connection of two organs or between an organ and the skin. The intestinal inflammation caused by diverticulitis may lead to the formation of fistulas that connect the large intestine to other organs. Fistulas usually form when an inflamed diverticulum on the large intestine gets in touch with another organ, like the bladder, for example. The resulting inflammation, together with the bacteria of the large intestine that penetrate the adjacent organ, form a fistula. The treatment of an intestinal fistula is done by a doctor, usually with surgery to correct the path, depending on the location and size. Perforation. Perforation is a serious complication of diverticulitis, which happens in advanced cases or when not treated correctly. It causes intense abdominal inflammation because of feces, which may contaminate the area. Any person can develop diverticulitis, being more common in the elderly. Its causes are related mainly to the poor functioning of the intestine. Also, people who smoke may present a higher risk of forming diverticula, since smoking weakens the intestinal walls. Diverticulitis can stay many years without presenting any symptoms, and sometimes is only found out by accident during a routine colonoscopy. However, when there are complications, like the symptoms we talked about, it may be necessary to do ultrasounds or an abdominal tomography to evaluate the seriousness and decide the best treatment. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more recipes and tips, subscribe to the channel.